Let us discuss about the eyeball. Eyeball is located in the bony depression, is called eye orbit. And eyeball is associated structures. These are eyelids, eyelashes, eyebrows, and lacrimal glands. These are the parts give protection to the eyeball. Student, lacrimal glands secretes lacrimal fluid, are called tears, which consist salts, mucus, lysozyme or lacrimal lysozyme enzyme, which kills the microorganisms which are enters into the eyeball. And eyeball is associated with the extrinsic muscles, six types of the muscles. Students, these are the muscles. Eye muscles receive innervations from 3rd, 4th, 6th cranial nerves, students. And entire the eyeball is divided into three parts: fibrous tunic, vascular tunic, nervous tunic. In this fibrous tunic, it is the outer coat of the eyeball, and with anterior cornea and posterior sclera, anterior cornea, posterior sclera. Cornea, what about cornea? Cornea is the non-vascular transparent part, covers the colored iris, student. These are iris. This is the iris. Covers the colored iris. This is cornea. And conjunctiva. What about conjunctiva? It is the cornea. Cornea covers with the thin layer, that is called conjunctiva. Next, sclera. It is the white part of the eyeball, student. It is the sclera. Student, it is the sclera. Sclera is the white part of the eyeball. It provides shape to the eyeball, student, and protects the inner part of the eyeball. Next, another one, student, vascular tunic. What about the vascular tunic? Vascular tunic, it is the middle layer. It is the middle layer of the eyeball and divides into choroid, ciliary body, iris. First one about the choroid. Choroid, it is, student, this is the choroid. This is the choroid. Choroid is bluish in color and highly vascular and thick anterior part of the choroid that forms the ciliary body. Student, it is the ciliary body. Student, it is the ciliary body. Okay. And ciliary body. What about ciliary body? Ciliary body is pigmented and vascularized. Smooth muscles associated with the ciliary body is called ciliary muscles. Okay. And smooth muscles of the ciliary body hold and alters the shape of the lens. This is the lens. Hold and alter the shape of the lens by smooth muscles of the ciliary body, called ciliary muscles. Next, iris. What about the iris? This is the iris, student. This is the iris. Iris is the colored portion of the eyeball and suspended between cornea and lens. Iris, it is the iris. Iris is suspended between cornea and lens. Okay, student, this is the iris, is the part in the eyeball between lens and the cornea. And what about the pupil? Pupil, aperture present between the center part of the iris. This is the center part of the iris. It is with the aperture like arrangement, student, that is called pupil. Okay. And iris regulate amount of the light. Iris regulate the amount of the light entered into the vitreous chamber. It is the chamber is called vitreous chamber by the pupil. Student, iris regulates the amount of the light that entered into the vitreous humor, vitreous chamber by the help of the pupil. Student, okay. Next, nervous tunic. What about the nervous tunic? Nervous tunic, it is also termed with the retina. Retina tunic means layer. Nervous tunic, vascular tunic. Tunic means layer. Next, fibrous tunic. Inner layer, it is the nervous tunic, and non-visual contain two types of the portions: non-visual portion and the visual portion. Non-visual portion of the retina, also called melanin portion, contain epithelial cells. Students, epithelial cells. Next, what about the visual portion of the retina? That consists of three layers. One is the photoreceptor cell layer, and bipolar cell layer, and ganglionic cell layer. Student, ganglion cell layer. What about photoreceptor layer? What about the photoreceptor layer in this? Photoreceptor layer consists of two types of cells. Photoreceptor layer consists of two types of cells. One is the rods, another one is the cones. Photoreceptor layer that consists of two types of the cells, rods and cones. What about the rods? Rods contain rhodopsin protein. Rods contain rhodopsin protein. Rhodopsin is the protein that is formed by combination of the vitamin A and the auxin. Rhodopsin is the protein. It plays main role or important in scotopic vision, or also called vision at the time of the low light conditions. Low light vision, scotopic vision, dim light vision. Okay. Next, what about the cones? Cones contain iodopsin. Cones contain iodopsin protein, pigment. It is important in daylight vision. It is important in daylight vision, colored vision. And cones, three types of the cells, three types of the cones present in it, in this region, in these cones. Cones are three types. Provides optimal response to the red color and green color and the blue color. Student, next, what about the yellow spot? Yellow spot is the center posterior portion of the retina. Student, this is the retina. The posterior portion of the retina is this region, and the center posterior part is called yellow spot. Student, and what about fovea centralis? Fovea centralis. Yellow spot is the region that shows the depression. That shows the depression. That is, the depression is called fovea. Student, fovea is important, plays main role in sharp vision at the time of the walking, running, reading, driving, like that. Next, another one. What about the optic nerve? Ganglionic cell present in the nervous tunic or the retina. Student, visual portion of the retina, that is with the ganglionic cell. Ganglionic cells having axons. Axons of the ganglionic cells extend to the posterior, student, and forms the optic nerve. This is the optic nerve. Next, another one. What about the blind spot? Blind spot, it is the part of the retina, region of the retina. Student, it is the entire part is retina, region of the retina, where the optic nerve is extends. Student, this is the region, this is the place for where the optic nerve is extends to the posterior. That is the region is called blind spot. Student, blind spot is with the absence of the photoreceptor cells. Okay. And another, what about lens? student, lens. Lens is locates in the inner part of the eyeball, and this is the lens divides entire the innermost part of the eyeball into two chambers. One is the aqueous chamber, second one is the vitreous chamber. Lens allows the light from the cornea, light rays are entered onto the retina by the help of the lens. Lens allows the light from the cornea onto the retina. Lens are held in position by the help of the suspensory ligaments. Okay, lens that divides the inner part of the eyeball into two chambers. One is the aqueous chamber, another one is the vitreous chamber. This is the aqueous chamber, this is the vitreous chamber. Student, what about the chambers of the eyeball? Chambers, inner part of the eyeball that shows two chambers. One is the aqueous chamber, another one is vitreous chamber. Aqueous chamber that is filled with the fluid-like substance that is called aqueous humor. Aqueous humor helps to nourish the cornea and the lens. Aqueous chamber present between cornea and the lens. Next, what about the vitreous chamber? Vitreous chamber present between cornea and the lens, student. And vitreous chamber that consists of fluid-like substance, jelly-like substance, that is called vitreous humor. Vitreous humor gives shape to the eyeball, student. Gives shape to the eyeball. It is about the vitreous chamber. Students, now mechanism of vision. Light rays focused on the retina via the conjunctiva, cornea and aqueous humor, pupil, lens, vitreous humor, finally reaches onto the retina. Students, light rays focused on the retina through cornea and lens generate action potential on rods and cones. Lens generate type of the action potential on the photoreceptor cells, which are called rods and the cones. Photoreceptor cells are two types, rods, cones. Rods cells contain rhodopsin protein, which is formed with the opsin and the vitamin A. Students, cones are the cells which contain iodopsin protein. Students, photosensitive compounds, which are the photosensitive, which shows sensitivity to the light, opsin and the retinol. Opsin, retinol are the photosensitive compounds. Next, at the same time, light induces dissociation of the retinol from the opsin. Students, retinol is divides, separates from the opsin by the light. Light induces dissociation of the retinol from the opsin, and it also causes changes in the structure of the opsin. Okay, students. And at the same time, it causes the produce of membrane permeability in photoreceptor cells. Produces membrane permeability in photoreceptor cells such as rods and the cones. At the same time, action potential develops in bipolar cells. This is the action potential is reaches into the ganglionic cells. And action potential develops, that one is the action potential is transmitted by the optic nerve to the visual cortex of the brain. Student, it is about the mechanism of the vision.